Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the React Kanban component from SyncFusion. In general, a Kanban board visually organizes and prioritizes your tasks with a transparent workflow. In this video, I am going to show you how to add a React Kanban component to a React app. Then, I will explain how to bind a data source to the Kanban, enable swim lanes in it, set a custom height and width, add tooltips and customize them, and validate specific columns. I am going to create my project with the help of the Create React App toolchain, which installs the latest version of React, React Dome, and React scripts. I will view and edit my code using Visual Studio Code, and view the output on one of the supported browsers. To create a new React project, I need to install Create React App globally on my machine using the command npm install -g create React App. As I have already installed it, I am skipping this step here. Now, let me create a new React project using the command create React App project name. I want to create a React App with TypeScript, so let me add -- template TypeScript to the existing command. I named my project Kanban component. This will create an empty React application with no SyncFusion packages. I will navigate to the newly created application. To start using the Kanban component, within this empty application, I install the Kanban package and its subcomponent packages using the command npm install at SyncFusion/ej2react-kanban --save. Once the installation is complete, my application is ready. The first thing I need to do here is open the app.tsx file and replace the default code with render method. Next, I import the Kanban component from the SyncFusion React Kanban package and add the React Kanban component within the render method of the React component. After that, I open the index.tsx file and import register license from the SyncFusion EJ2 base package. Then, I register the SyncFusion React trial license key by using the method registerLicense. The SyncFusion React license key registration is required from the 2022 Volume 1 release onward. Next, I define the CSS for the Kanban. I can either import the React Kanban component CSS in the app.css file or reference the CDN link in the index.html file. To make it simple, I choose the second option. So, let me open the index.html file and reference the CDN link inside the head section, which includes the combined CSS references of all the essential JS2 React components. Now, I will start to initialize the component. To do so, I need to define the columns in the Kanban board. First, I define the columns directive tag, which accepts n number of column directive definitions. I am going to define 5 different workflow status columns: to do, in progress, review, testing, and close. So, let me add 5 column directive tags with appropriate header text. Then, the columns and column directive are automatically imported from the SyncFusion React Kanban package. Next, I will add header text and key field properties within these columns and set appropriate values to them. I am going to run this example using the command npm start. Here, you can see the Kanban component rendered with the 5 different workflow statuses. Next, I will show you how to populate cards for the Kanban board. To populate cards, first, I create an object named Kanban DataSource and assign an array of objects with 8 fields, namely ID, title, status, summary, type, priority, estimate, and assignee. Then, I assign this object to the DataSource property. Now, I will add a key field for this Kanban component and set it values to status. Here, the Kanban board will render the cards based on the workflow status defined in the DataSource. Looking at this Kanban board, we can see the cards are empty. Suppose I want to show details in the cards, then I need to define the card settings property within this Kanban code. I plan to display the cards with task IDs and summary content, so let me define content field and header field properties with appropriate values mapped from DataSource. You can see the cards in the Kanban board are now displayed with task IDs and task summaries. By default, the Kanban board height and width property values are auto. However, you can set custom values in pixels or percentages. I am going to set a custom height and width for the Kanban board using pixel values. So, let me define height and width properties with appropriate values inside the Kanban code. See the output page now, the Kanban board is rendered with the custom height and width. Notice here, the tasks are categorized based on the task status. If I want to display the tasks based on assignee, then I need to define the swim lane settings property and set the key field property as assignee within this Kanban code. I plan to set 100% width and height for the Kanban board, so let me define height and width properties with the 100% value within this Kanban code. Now, you can see the tasks are categorized based on the assignee field. Next, I will show how to enable tooltips for the cards. All I have to do is define enable tooltip and set its value as true within this Kanban code. Now a tooltip is shown for every card in the task board. Let's take it a step further and customize the tooltips using the tooltip template property. I want to show assignee, task type, estimate, and summary in each tooltip. To do this, I define a method, card tooltip template of type JSX element, which returns a JSX element. Here, I will add a division and a table with table row elements. As I said before, I am going to display these data fields in the tooltip, so let me add assignee, type, estimate, and summary fields using the data parameter. And I also set appropriate header text for each table row. Then, I assign this card tooltip template method to the tooltip template property. Look at this output page now, the customized tooltip is shown for every card. By default, you can select only one card at a time. Suppose, I want to select multiple cards, then, I need to set the selection type as multiple within this card settings property. With that done, I can now select multiple cards in the task board. Next, I will show you how to validate the columns in the task board. I am going to validate the testing and review columns, so let me define min count and max count properties with appropriate values. See the output page now, the testing column card count falls short of the minimum count value, so the yellow background color shows validation fails. In the review column, the total number of cards count exceeds maximum count value, so the pink background is applied to indicate that validation fails. Next, I will show you how to bind a remote data source to the component. To bind the remote data, I am going to use Syncfusion's Data Manager library. This data manager acts as a gateway between the Kanban component and the data source and uses queries to interact with both local and remote data sources. As a first step, I import the data manager and the required adapter from the Syncfusion EJ2 data package. Then, I define the data manager with properties like URL, adapter, and cross-domain. In the URL, I will be using the already available remote URL service, which will retrieve the list of data through a post action and bind the resultant data to the Kanban. Also, I have set OData adapter here, as the URL is assigned to an existing OData service. The cross-domain option is set to true to allow the cross-origin domain request. Now, I assign the Kanban remote data source object to the data source property and make sure the remote data source status value and Kanban component column key field values are same. In the output, you can see the Kanban component displays the remote data source tasks in the cards. Also, the testing column cards count exceeds the maximum count value, and review column cards count falls short of the minimum count value, so the pink and yellow background color shows validation fails. Notice here, the Kanban swim lane layout is shown in mobile mode. By default, the Kanban swim lane grouped header text is selected, and the resultant data is shown on the board. The Kanban board data can be changed by clicking the menu icon at the top. If I want to show the Kanban board in the default layout, then I will disable the swim lane option by removing the swim lane settings property from the Kanban code. Now, in the default layout, this column occupies 80% of the screen layout and another column occupies 20%. Swipe left and right to view the columns. Let's recap what we have done in this video. We saw how to create an application with the Create React App tool and how to add the Kanban component to it. We saw how to bind local and remote data sources, add and customize tooltips, set a custom height and width for the board, select multiple cards, and change the default layout. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire React suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.